Hi, it's Larry here from Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show, here with Jeffrey. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, how we doing?
This is the pre-E3 show.
Pre-3 show.
Stop
trying to make pre-3 happen.
That's what it happened. That's why I've been trying for years. And
No.
Anyway, we're in the studio. We wanted to bang out a quick show because next week, well, we actually just got off a whole one of many conference calls about E3, didn't we?
Yeah. It's pretty much E3, the conference call. That's pre-3 right there.
And I don't know about you, Jeff, but you know, when we're listening on these conference calls, where there's all these different elements that are being discussed, you know, certainly the briefing and all this operational stuff, who goes where, what door we're going in.
It's amazing how complex
this is incredible. But it's always fun when we're listening to the call and you and I will lock eyes and wait a minute, are we doing that? Wow. You know, you get excited.
Yeah.
So we get excited just like everybody else does. So
As much work as it is, and this will be my 13th E3, I know you're at least 16
or 18.
It's always fun. It's all like,
yeah,
when we get to the point where the lights go down,
yeah,
we're just like you. We're sitting there and just soaking in the
show.
Let's
see how it goes.
Yep.
It's exciting. So looking forward to that. That's coming up just to mark your calendars. That is coming up Sunday, June 9th at 1:00 Pacific. That's 4:00 Eastern will be our briefing, and it'll be streamed on wherever the heck, yeah, you know.
9 p.m. British summertime.
That's right, 9 p.m. British summertime, BST. So we got that going on. It's going to be fun. It's going to be exciting. So we're looking forward to that. But we want to get in the studio. We got to bang out some news, talk about a few things that went out over the past couple weeks.
This is not a quiet zone.
You were on the road. Can we talk
about
that?
As were you, right? Weren't you at EDC? I thought I saw you. You had like sort of the shin guard sort of situation,
yes,
that everyone wears at EDC. That wasn't you?
That wasn't me.
I thought it was you.
No.
I was on the East Coast for most of the last 2 weeks.
Yep.
It's weird working on the West Coast, but being on the East Coast, you have nice quiet mornings.
Yeah, you weren't taking a vacation. You had some stuff.
No, taking care of some family stuff. Of course, I travel. Actually, thank you very much, Larry, for lending me an Xbox One X, an extra one. I didn't want to take apart my home theater and all that stuff. My everything, you know, we run the TV through it. That does not go.
You told me you'd do that. And look, I got an extra one for you.
And a games case. And I sat down there. And you know what?
The game screen.
Game screen. Yeah, I guess it was the second gen one that they had. And you know what? It was perfect. I played a ton of games.
Not only that. Wait a minute.
What?
Is that when we got our Apex win?
We did.
Were down there?
Yeah, I got two of them down there.
What, the one with your daughter, though?
Yeah.
Okay, so we got it.
We were in three different places,
and it actually worked.
Yeah, so. That was a heck of a game.
That was a heck of a game. You got the final kill.
I did.
There were people like giving you some stuff on Twitter because you weren't strafing or you didn't have proper form. It doesn't matter. It got the job done.
And I did it with Gibraltar.
Yeah.
He's a thick boy.
Yeah.
He, there's a lot of surface area, and I was using an R99 at range.
Yes.
And finished off just unloading a clip. That's a proud moment. That's as good as it's going to get for me.
It absolutely is. Anyway, we're cooking along here. We've got a lot to do. We figure we'll go over some of the news, and you want to jump on it.
What are you playing? I haven't seen you.
Talking about Apex, Rage 2. You and I are playing Rage 2.
What do you think about that?
Well, it's fun. It's a fun, you know, we have so many of these intense multiplayer games like, you know, that we've been playing a Division and what have you. And this is nice to just have a single player experience where you just kind of go in and pick up, play for a half hour, put it down, come back 20 minutes later or whatever, just kind of dip in and out of it, right?
I mean, we both love the Far Cry series.
Right.
We love our open world FPSs.
Yes.
And this is just like that 60 frames per second, silky smooth,
yeah,
sort of like gunplay it's just phenomenal.
Yeah.
It really just feels good. It's just fun at like a core level at all times. And I don't recall getting into the original Rage all that much. And if you,
nor do I.
I got a couple questions just from some friends as I was sort of saying, oh, you know, I'm really getting into this. And they were like, do I have to have played the first one? No. I'm going to tell you, no.
No.
And I wouldn't say Rage 2 is a game you're necessarily playing for the story, because a lot of times it just boils down to, and even your character admits this, let me guess, I got to go in there and blow a bunch of stuff up.
Right.
Yep, that's what you're going to be doing. It has one of the best shotguns in gaming history.
Oh, it's that would be kind of OP.
Yeah, it's phenomenal when you aim down the sight.
And it blows them back.
It has like a shockwave blast,
yeah,
like a sort of a slug. When you shoot something down, it's got some range, especially when you boost it up. And one of the things I was wondering, because I'd played, I don't know, 10 hours of the first Rage, and one of the things that I wanted to see in Rage 2 was if you had any sort of progression or ability unlocks, and how.
Yeah, you do.
There's so many. There's like so many different facets of what you do. While it doesn't have like XP, you're constantly earning different currencies, different minerals, different coins of that allow you to do all these different things. And it encourages you to just slide in there and do this little side mission that you happen to see as you're driving by. Oh, I got to blow up this gas station.
Right.
Well, I've got a pocket full of grenades.
We can take
and a rocket
care of that.
Launcher.
Yeah.
I'd be more than happy to do this.
Keep the engine running. I'll be right back.
Exactly. And it just does a lot of things really right at like that fundamental feel level that I'm pretty close to beating it. And I'll definitely finish it before E3. But yeah, great job to, you know, Bethesda. And I think it was Avalanche
yeah.
that put that together. These yeah. are the folks that I believe they do Just Cause, right?
Yep, they do.
Which has some updates, which we'll get to actually in a minute. But that was exactly the game I needed, I think, while I was sort of away from my family and just sort of had these nights where I didn't really have a lot to do. And
what do you mean? I kept your nights busy. We were playing.
Well, between Apex yeah. and, yeah, until you got online.
Yeah, that's true, because you were ahead of me.
You know, I was ahead of you. It was a lot of Rage.
So yeah, I've been playing that, Rage 2, Apex, of course, mm-hmm. Overwatch jumped back into with the new season.
So did I. Yeah.
Check that out last night, in fact. Sea of Thieves with their latest update, which is fun.
Yeah, I'm Thanks, quite the Briggsy. Fisherman. Quite the fisherman.
You are.
I like it. Once you figure out the knack on there, yep. every time we're sailing anywhere, you just cast the line off, and it's fun. And then you cook them, and then they sell them.
Borderlands, playing that. Also talked about the game
Which
of the
one?
Year. The game of the year.
The game of the year edition.
Yeah, yep. You'll see that on there. So yeah, I've been busy. You've been busy. Lots sure, been huh? busy. But it's going to become. We have to kind of taper off our gameplay because we're going
to
be busy with games.
I know.
With game news.
Yeah. I feel like this time of year. Oftentimes it can get a little bit quiet. You can get quiet in terms of game releases. It
sure.
can get quiet in terms of news. That's not the case this year.
Nope.
There's been so much coming out, so much to talk about, so much to play. It's just, you know, we're always on. And I mean, I'm not complaining about it.
No, it's gonna be a fun time. We've got a busy summer ahead of us. We've got a lot of stuff we're working on that we can't talk about yet.
Yeah, and some that we can talk about, like you know, Halo, Outpost. That we'll be going to a couple different places. And,
Orlando.
Yeah.
Jeffrey's former hometown.
I feel like it's almost as if I picked like where we're going.
Yeah, where we're going.
The city, so Orlando, where I used to live in Orlando, and then I'm from Philly. We're going to Philly.
Yeah.
So I'm like telling all my relatives, I'm like, hey, why don't you come on out to Halo Outpost Discovery? You see me.
Yep.
You see
Master Chief, yeah.
presumably.
And a lot of fans.
And a Warthog and all these other things. So it's pretty much looking forward to that. My sister now, she spends half her year in Chicago. We're going to Chicago.
Oh.
So
that's right. We can put a link and we'll put a link to where you can
yeah,
sign up for that.
I will do that. Yeah, tickets are on sale now. I believe some of the VIP 3-day stuff is starting to sell out. So you probably want to get on it. And they also announced that if you do, and I'm going to get the story right. So I'm just bringing it up real quick that you get, I believe it's 6 months of Xbox Game Pass. Yeah, all VIP tickets now include 6 months of Xbox Game Pass. So, I mean,
why not?
There's a good value there
yeah.
of what, $9.99 a month and, you know, times six. And you get into Outpost Discovery. So,
and you may be able to get to meet some of Jeff's relatives.
They're going to be floating around there.
You've been warned.
Yes.
Is your mom coming?
Not a lot to say.
Is your mom coming up?
She said, hey, maybe I'll. Now, the reason I was down there, my mom had major surgery.
Yeah.
I was down there literally, like, you know, in between conference calls, I'm like chopping garlic and then going on mute and, you know, it's cooking yeah. and keeping the house together, feeding the dog.
You were fixing
like
things?
Fixing all of the. I feel like she saves all the.
Well, that's what they do.
This door isn't closing right, or this drawer's falling apart.
Could you take a look at this?
Yeah. Can you help me? There was a lot of moving of heavy objects.
There's all these bars in my browser, Jeffrey. Could you remove them?
It's funny. I did have to update. She had like a Surface RT.
Right. Oh, wow.
From
old school.
That I'd given her back in like 2013. And
right.
she was like, can you help me with? And I was like, yes, I can help you with this.
Good.
Yeah. Still using it. She still likes it. She was like, maybe I'll come up to Orlando. And I was like, you know, you just had major surgery.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of walking. Maybe.
The middle of the summer.
Maybe I come to you.
Yeah.
Maybe I come
Can to we?
Oh, actually, you know, she would love to meet you.
I've never met her.
She's a huge
fan
of
yours. She and I chatted, but I've never met her.
I know. So she no longer calls you Captain Morgan.
That's okay.
Which I think is a big step forward.
We're getting forward there.
Yeah.
So. Anyway, so we got a big thing with a Halo Outpost. Discovery is going to be great.
Yeah. So you're going to come with me?
I would love to.
All right. Well, we'll talk more about that, I think, after E3.
Yeah, when we get
closer. That's right around July 4th.
Right now, there's people listening right now saying, don't talk about that. Talk about E3. Well, look, we're not gonna give you up any news. We don't know what the news is. Well, you know,
maybe
just a couple things, but you're gonna have to tune in for E3 for that.
Yeah. Look, it's gonna be fun to just sit down there, lights go down, enjoy it, watch it, stream it.
Where do you watch it from? I can't remember. Do you watch
where
it?
Where do I watch E3?
Yeah.
So it's part of my job is getting like, you know, creators, streamers, right, YouTubers, and all that stuff into the building. That's the reason I'm there.
Which, by the way, sounds like, why would he need help getting people? You'd be surprised with all the security and...
We have like 10 minutes.
Right.
I mean, maybe slightly more, but not by much.
There's
to get people
window
through security,
yep,
into the seats, and that thing
in
needs
the right
to start
seats, in the right
seats.
Right.
Exactly. And it needs to start on time. And so...
Phil's not waiting.
No. And so all of that, and then usually what ends up happening is then I'm like, it's dark, the lights go down, I get the last person in the door, and then I'm like, where can I sit?
Yeah, you're seat filling at that point.
And last year, which was our first year in the Microsoft Theater, I had to like go into the upper deck. So I actually missed the first...
Oh, that's right, I remember that. You were way up on top.
Yeah, so it was the first... I missed like the first minute of the Halo Infinite trailer,
right,
and I had never seen it.
Sure.
So it was, you know, but I was sitting in my seat for like the point where people realized what it was.
Yeah, where he brings
and, like,
the helmet shot.
It was
shot.
Like, I still get chills thinking about it.
Yeah.
That was amazing. So that's where I'll be. Where do you watch it
from? Usually in the, if you're looking down to the stage, I'm watching it from the right-hand side. We have a workspace up there, you know, where those boxes are?
Yeah, yeah.
But that aren't filled. So
yeah,
it's just kind of like this empty space, and I usually just find a stool and sit down.
You
and
know
just
what?
Watch.
Save me a seat.
Let's do it.
Let's do that. This
so if you,
year.
If you were able to attend, if you got tickets to FanFest and you're joining us, look up to the right.
Yeah,
you
may, there's tons of fans.
Jeff
there
and Larry will be sitting there like
know,
the two
like,
old guys from the Muppet Show.
Exactly like that.
Because that's exactly where we're going to be up in that area.
Ripping off zingers and one-liners.
So there you go.
All right.
What else? You got some news. You
want
to go through some news?
Yeah, so we introduced the new Xbox Game Bar.
Yes,
this week
on Windows 10.
On Windows 10. So if you are gaming on Windows 10, as we are, whether it's Xbox Play Anywhere titles, of which there are many, or you're just doing other gaming, there are a lot of features for gamers. If you previously hit Windows G before this week, you would have like a little strip of things there where you could start to record or you could do whatever. But now
it was a bar.
Yeah. There is a tremendous customizable experience that includes the features from that, but like really in-depth audio sliders, Spotify, if you want to do that. Larry just brought
it
up on his
computer
right there. And
got your
friends
list,
your chat window. You know, if you're broadcasting on Mixer, you can see that LFG looking for group. You put up there what you want up there in terms of overlays, and you hit Windows G, it pops up and you have access to all that. Previously, if you wanted to party up, you would launch the Xbox app and you would toggle back and forth from the game, and it worked. But this is a much more seamless expression of that.
You do, there are some requirements though.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to do certain things. Can we put a link in what you need to do?
I'm going to do that, yeah, just so none of that stuff is lost. But the insiders, all you guys really helped us, develop this and hone this and refine this. And so we thank you, and we think you'll enjoy this.
That is fun. I'm just looking at the animation the design team did.
Yeah, yeah, and there's like a really cool animated GIF. I'm doing this again. We were talking about that would make a really good shirt.
Yeah.
Anyway, so we'll link out to that. And... you should try it out. It's literally just a keystroke away.
Mm-hmm.
Away.
Links below.
Yeah, I'm like putting it in there.
Well, if you listen on SoundCloud or wherever, YouTube, head over to my blog at majordelson.com. That's where the link
you'll see
is.
You'll see it. Another update
what else you got?
That ended up, we actually just slightly before recording, Kareem Chaudhry, who is the corporate vice president of Gaming Cloud.
I love talking to him.
Yeah, you've gotten to interview him on Inside Xbox in the past.
Yeah, I actually was talking with him last week about some stuff. It's fun.
So he's in charge of Project xCloud. And now he's talking turkey, you know, like we've talked, you've seen some demos we've had, and we've talked sort of theoretically. We're showing off like actually what the servers look like. And the fact that there's these, what do we call them, blades?
Yep.
That serve up the games. Like,
I've held one.
Really?
Yeah, I've seen one. I was down there. I pictured
it. Cradle it. Did you have to put on like, well, the gloves, I'm sure. Did you have to put on like the full like hazmat suit?
No, they had a sample one out and I was playing. I can't really talk about it, but it was really cool. I'll tell you off.
All right.
I'll tell you off, Mike.
Well, what you held is now across 13 Azure regions, you know, in North America, Asia, and Europe. Capcom, we're working with Capcom, we're working with Paradox Interactive. Those are a couple of development teams that have been mentioned. I'll link out to this, but it's interesting. It's exciting to see, you know, probably not a ton of game developers listening, you know, to the show. Then again,
you never know. I bet you there are.
But we're basically talking about how game developers don't have to really make changes or modifications in order to empower their games for xCloud.
Yeah.
So
to optimize it.
What does that ultimately mean?
What does it mean?
That means it's going to be a lot of games.
Yeah.
And so, just reading here, this means Project xCloud has the technical capability to stream more than 3,500 games without changes or modifications. Well, that sounds pretty good. And they also mentioned another 1,900 games are in development for Xbox One, all of which could run on Project xCloud. Ooh. So, and then right now we're testing internally. Yeah. You and I have the ability to, fire it up.
Yeah,
when we need to.
Yeah, yes. That's all.
All we can say.
That's all I can say.
But it's just really cool. So I'm going to link out to that if you're interested in Project xCloud. This is it's not a long
everybody
read.
Else is.
It's well worth your time to take a look at that.
Fun.
And we'll link over to that on, of course, majornelson.com.
Yes.
Let's talk about games, Larry.
Well, we just did. Oh, games coming out that came out?
Games that have come out,
yes.
That are coming out,
yes.
That are included,
yes.
With Xbox Game Pass. They've
best deal in gaming.
They're really outdoing themselves. So May and into June. So we announced like a few weeks ago a bunch of games coming in May.
Yes.
Now it's like, oh, we weren't done.
Yeah.
You didn't think we were
done. What?
No. So just a couple days ago, we talked about more games coming. So I'll just rattle them off. Metal Gear Survive, Banner Saga, and Banner Saga 2.
I remember you playing those.
Yeah, I beat the first Banner Saga and I'm about halfway through Banner Saga 2. It's a strategy RPG where you make a lot of decisions.
Right.
And let me just tell you, the decisions you make, this isn't like, they're like fake decisions and it doesn't really matter. They make a huge difference in how the game ends up, and then it carries over. And at the end of Banner Saga 1, I made a decision that I still regret to this day, because I ended up resulting in the death of a character. Right. And like, as soon as you pick up in Banner Saga 2, you have the ability to, you can either have like the quote unquote canon ending, or you can pull in all your decisions. And then, you know, I had to live with what I had done in a previous game, and it was just devastating. Yeah. I still feel that way. Has a cool animated look. And this is some tough strategy stuff. So if you like an SRPG, this is definitely one for you. And yet at the same time,
and who doesn't?
They do make the achievements rain. So I highly recommend. These are not 80-hour games. These are like narrative driven, and you can play through. I'm not going to throw a number out there, but
they're manageable.
They're manageable.
Yeah.
This isn't something where you need to set
aside
the
next
3 months.
Right.
And really good writing, really good animation, really enjoyable. This is a game that I was fortunate enough to get to be the first to utter publicly.
That's right.
Void Bastards.
I remember that. When you did XO, right?
I was at XO.
XO, right. XO in Mexico City.
Yes. And I got to play the game at GDC, and the game is coming out next week.
Woo!
And it's coming out directly into Xbox Game Pass. So this is like again, really cool animated, reminded me a little bit of Futurama a bit. But it's an FPS an FPS roguelike, and there's just a lot of interesting stuff happening here. And if you have Game Pass, and of course you do, you'll get to try it out on day one for free. Dead by Daylight, that is coming out. Super Hot, remember Super Hot?
Yeah, I like that.
That's a really good game
where you have to make your shots.
Nothing moves until you move.
Right,
and
nothing
so
moves
it's,
until
it's,
you move.
It's as much a it's like
this
a
weird
puzzle,
3D puzzle FPS
puzzle shooter. Yeah. There's a RPG on a multiplayer RPG, Full Metal Furies, that's coming, and then another game that's coming out, brand new, debuting directly in Xbox Game Pass, literally the day after Void Bastards, May 30th, is Outer Wilds. And this game looks really cool. You're journeying through like an entire solar system, but you're on land. You can go up into space. It's like a space exploration, story-driven puzzle. You have a jetpack. You have to have jetpacks.
Yeah, jetpacks make everything better.
So this just looks really good. There was a great trailer. I'm going to link to the trailer.
Please.
Because there was a really good one that they released earlier this week. And I'm really excited to be playing this. And the fact that I already own it.
What's wrong with that?
Because I have Xbox Game Pass. Like, it's coming to me. And so...
You already own it.
We don't have time.
Right.
But I'm going to have to make the time. Because both Void Bastards and Outer Wilds are definitely worth your time. As well as Dead by Daylight, which a lot of people like. And I need to finish Banner Saga 2. There's just so much to play there.
There always is. There always is. Especially when you have Game Pass.
Yes.
Endless play.
Endless amount of play. Another game came out this week. It's free. By Epic Games.
Yes.
You may have heard
of them. Our friends at Epic.
Yeah. You may have heard of the old Fortnite.
Mm-hmm.
What they did with the Jordans, by the way, those Air Jordan 1s. Did you see this? Did
yes,
I talk to you
I
about
did.
But it? Not just the Jordans in the game. Yes. So there's a couple of Jordan 1s that yes. are dropping.
Are these the 1997 ones?
These are like going
you know
back
those.
To 85.
You know
these
those.
Are the Jordan
I had a pair
1s.
Of those.
You had Jordan 97s?
Why? Who wouldn't?
Which one were those?
We'll
come back to it.
I misread you. Apologies.
Air Max 97. Those are pretty hot.
Those are the ones.
Maybe those. That seems like more your style, low top. So they're in the game, but then in real life, there's some really cool ones that are coming out where if they scuff, they come out tomorrow, Saturday, as we're recording this.
The drop, as they call it.
The drop. You got to cop the drop.
Yes.
Or take an L. Anyway. If they scuff, they reveal another layer of color. So you actually, normally you want to keep your shoes pristine. You scuff them. You might as well throw them out.
Right.
These, you actually want to wear them. And anyway, you could buy you were able to, if you had played the Air Jordan mode, the Jumpman mode in Fortnite, you would reveal a spray, which then you could scan using your sneakers app and it would do an AR thing. And that would unlock the shoe and you could get it ahead of time. That just blows my mind.
It's advertising.
It is, but it doesn't feel like advertising when it's all a bunch of stuff I like.
Yep. Okay.
So anyway, really cool. Anyway, Epic Games, they have a game, an MMO called Dauntless that just came out on Xbox One for free this week. Hearing some good things. You slay like these giant monsters. Obviously, it's Epic Games. This is going to be a very well-developed game.
Yep.
So I'm definitely, where I'm going to find time to work an MMO in my life, I don't know, but this is one that I think is, you know, I at least want to try it. I hear it feels really good.
Right.
Here's another one. Team Sonic Racing. Sonic Team Racing.
Yeah,
this is newer.
We had it on this week on Xbox last week.
So that is coming out
this week.
Sonic's also trending worldwide for some reason right now. So, that is out now. And that is at the-
Sonic, just Sonic?
Well, it's Team Sonic.
Because it could be a hamburger.
It could. Or like they do really interesting soft drinks as well.
Yes, they do.
Yeah,
that's a place here.
I have not had lunch.
Place here in the United States.
Don't derail me. Don't derail me.
Mm.
So here's a game I think you were trying out, the Dragon's Lair trilogy.
That's right. Yeah.
Tell me.
I haven't tried it out yet.
Okay.
I was like, I have to try this out to see how it's going to compare, because we all remember the old Dragon's Lair, which was one of the original. It was a Don Bluth animation.
Yep.
Don Bluth used to work at Disney, and remember that he did.
He did Secret of
an
Nim.
American Tale.
Yeah.
And others.
Yeah.
And one of the original
Laserdisc
games, right. Video disc games.
From like the 90s, right?
Oh, God. Late 80s, early 90s. Yeah. So it's definitely something I want to check out.
I just remember that it was really expensive to play in the arcade.
Right.
And now you can just like own it, all three of them for $20. I mean, you know, and I think that we might have had it before in previous generations, but if there's a generation, there's a Dragon's Lair.
Right.
So, and just another game I just wanted to point out real quickly. This is an indie game and priced accordingly from Curve Digital. American Fugitive. It reminds me of, remember when people think of Grand Theft Auto?
Yes.
They really mean Grand Theft Auto 3 and beyond.
And beyond, right.
When it fully went 3D. But the first two Grand Theft Autos were like top-down affairs.
Right.
Where it was still open world. And I remember playing it and it was still revelatory at that time, because there wasn't a game like it, but then when GTA 3 came out, we were not ready. American Fugitive seems like if you were to remake one of like GTA 1 and 2 in the modern era, what would that look like? So it's still mostly top-down. I'll tell you what it would look like. It would look a lot like American Fugitive.
Yeah.
So it looks interesting. It looks worth your, you know, worth a shot. I haven't played it yet, but it definitely caught my eye, and so I wanted to pass that on to you.
Yes.
Check it out. Take a look. And a couple other games coming out next week. Layers of Fear 2. This looks really scary. You're playing as a Hollywood actor who heeds the call of an enigmatic director to take the lead in a film shoot aboard an ocean liner. They're alone, you know.
My heart will go on. Titanic? Could be.
It could be.
Okay.
It could be. The goal is to find the heart of the ocean. Cricket 19. I know you're a big cricket fan.
I don't understand that game. I want to, but I just don't understand it.
It's like baseball, but like inning lasts forever.
But it takes two weeks to play.
And they bounce the ball. Anyway, and you can hit it in any direction. That's out next week. It is Xbox One X Enhanced. Outer Wilds, like we had mentioned. Warhammer Chaos Bane. This one is Xbox One X Enhanced. And you can play it solo or with up to four people in local or online co-op. And PixArk, another Xbox One X Enhanced game, which is... it has a purple dragon, so I immediately think of Spyro, so except it's more pixely.
Right.
And then another RPG, actually, like an RPG action strategy card battler, also Xbox One X Enhanced. Thank you very much. Gollum Gates, and that will be out on May 31st. And then one game that became available for pre-order this week that I'm very much looking forward
Which one?
To, Bloodstained Ritual of the Night.
Yes.
So this is Igarashi, yes. Igarashi-san, who is the creator of Castlevania. And yes. Actually, I think there was a Castlevania, like sort of the original three games have been remastered recently and right. re-released. I love me some Castlevania 2 and 3. So this is sort of the spiritual successor. These guys released an amazing trailer because we've been hearing about this game for a while. And it was first revealed, I don't remember exactly when, but people had a lot of feedback, let's say, on the game. And they took that feedback and they've enhanced it and made it look, you know, they've owned up to not meeting the expectations of certain fans in a very hilarious way in the trailer, which I will link out to. And anyway, now it's looking better than ever and it's out on June 17th. So really shortly after we get back from E3, this is what I'll be jumping into. And it's coming out and you can pre-order it now.
Yay.
Last thing, we mentioned Avalanche.
We did Avalanche
Just
Games.
Cause. Just Cause 4 actually just released a big spring update that improved everything from the world's lighting, add more things to do, improve the combat AI. There's new mobile chaos objects, destructible metal train bridges. You're going to be able to blow more stuff up than ever.
Right.
And you like to do that.
Well, who doesn't? That's what Just Cause is all about.
I mean, yeah, tornadoes. Anyway, it's always great to see a developer continue to support their game and make it better.
Post-launch.
And yes, and that's what the developers of Just Cause 4 have done for you, the gamer.
All right, you ready?
For?
The big, well, it's on now. It ends Tuesday. The big back compat sale.
Oh yes,
all the games,
the biggest ever.
Like, just it's the go look at this. It's go to my blog majornelson.com and pinned to the top is this. This is the blog post that has all of the details on it and all the sales. But just go check it out for yourself. But if you want to go revisit some classics and own them digitally, now is the time, my friend.
And there's
now
stuff in there that's been enhanced for Xbox One X. Looks better than ever.
Yep,
you're gonna want to get on that.
Yeah.
There is now. I think I was reading something in the neighborhood of 560.
There is. There is
360 games, more than 360, 360 games.
Way more.
That's just amazing.
It's extraordinary.
That team has done.
They're still churning them out. I mean, it's I love those guys and girls. They are some smart cookies down there.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Engineers.
Are
yes.
we done?
I mean, yeah, that's all the news I've got. Isn't that enough for you?
Well, it is. I mean, we're headed into E3. We talked about
2 weeks away.
2 weeks away. We got a lot going on. You can join us virtually or in person for those of you that are going to FanFest. We'll look forward to seeing you.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot in store. So we're not going to do a show next week. We were able to do one this week. Jeff was traveling, so we couldn't get in. But we wanted to get in the studio and at least talk a little bit because we hadn't been in so long. So. There you go.
Here we are.
All right.
Anything else? You have any, look, it was mostly me talking. No, this but is Major Nelson Radio.
No, it is, but it's more of the royal Major Nelson. It's we. Now, if you have any questions, feel free to hit us up on Twitter at Major Nelson. If you have any complaints, you hit them up at Jeff Rubenstein.
Yeah, always.
Always on
I love
Twitter.
Your complaints.
You know what I'm working on? I got this new this is in the quasi gadgets section. I have a new washlet for my house.
Go on.
No, just for those of you who don't know, Jeff and I...
We love our fancy toilets.
Independently, we have fallen in love with the plumbing in Japan.
It's a wonderful country, and that's the piece you can bring home with you.
Yeah, it sure is. So I have this Kohler, which is an American company. I believe mm-hmm. they're an American company. They have sent me one of their washlets, and I've been testing that. I'll post some photos.
Okay.
It's quite fancy, as you would imagine.
Can I come over and try
it? Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
I would love to do that.
You can go bounce between the three different toilets.
I just want to see.
Yeah.
It's one of those things where I invite people over and I'm like, please, here's a magazine.
Yeah. Here's the instructions.
Here's some nice music.
Here's the instructions.
I'm going to leave you alone.
Yeah. We'll see you later. Have fun. Yeah. Highly recommend it. It
should be part of the Kohler Toto
influencer program. We absolutely are, for Pete's sakes.
This is an unpaid endorsement.
You have to understand how important this is.
I feel like your life improves
significantly.
And I want
I'll tell you what I'm looking forward to. This is a little bit inside baseball. Can I tell you?
How very inside.
Can I tell you?
Go.
Because you went through this. You have walked this path. I'm looking forward to teaching my daughter how to use it.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
So she's not quite there yet, but she will be.
No. It's our duty. As fathers,
yes.
To make sure our daughters have a better life
right.
than we had growing
right.
up.
And they can carry on this mantle that we have exactly. decided to take up. All right, I think that's, let's end it on that note.
I guess if you've been listening to the show this long,
yep.
you expect it.
Now, just a quick programming note, we talked about it, we talked about the briefing, which is Sunday.
Sunday, June 9th.
We will be doing Inside Xbox. Should we tell folks when we're doing that?
Yeah. We're doing it on Monday.
I don't know what the time is.
I don't know either.
I should be, let me just double check. Do you have it in front of you?
Looks like other people have been searching for it because it auto-filled on the search engine. I don't think we have issued the time.
All I know is it's Monday.
Yeah.
So it's Monday, the day after our briefing. We'll have a Inside Xbox, which is I'll be on the show. Jeff will be on the show. The rest of the cast of characters will be on the show. We'll talk about everything.
I can't wait to get out there. Yeah. I haven't been on in a while, so it'll be
fun. I think later Wednesday, 2 days later, we're doing our show. This show, Major Nelson Radio, on Mixer.
So then you know what we get to do?
What
is we got to play a bunch of games?
Yeah, well,
so we can talk about.
Well, I'm going to see who we can get on for guests. I think I got one of those guests that we talked about earlier. I think I'll try to get that person, right?
Oh, yes. That would be great.
I'll try to get that person.
That would be great.
So we'll see.
I can't wait. I'm so excited.
We are excited. You know what? We are.
Next 2 weeks is going to fly by.
Yep. So, all right, we're going to wrap it up because we got to get ready. Thank you for listening, downloading the show and listening to it. Again, hit me on Twitter at Major Nelson. You can hit the blog at majornelson.com to find out more details, a lot of what Jeff talked about. And then, Jeff, they can find you on social where?
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Now, what about do you have an Instagram for your shoe collection?
It's the same thing.
It is. So,
well, I guess not at.
If you really like Asian food and shoes,
coffee,
Jeff's
coffee.
The man. And coffee.
Mostly coffee.
And coffee.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Love me some coffee.
All right, gang. We'll see you. We'll see you in a few weeks at E3. Thank you, and get ready. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.